Rick the Railroad Guy. You must be Wally.
Yes, I am.
Great to meet you. Hey, I got some stuff to show you and your wife. You got a couple minutes?
Sure.
Let's go play trains. Train. We're looking for your ideas, what you want out of the railroad. The first question is always the most important. What's the name of your railroad?
We want to call it CNR Railroad.
We were thinking a big mountain over here with a tunnel through it and then have the water come down the side of the mountain.
If it wasn't for crazy, I wouldn't have a job. I actually had a guy wanted me to teach his trains how to swim, and we learned, we figured it out. Unfortunately, the wife put a kibosh to it, but it was a good idea. We've made 12-foot tall trestles. We've made 100-foot long bridges. We've got tunnels spiraling.
Showed off to the neighbors and friends.
I always check with the wife first. I've gotten in more trouble. Get your trowels out, get the garden hose out. Just kind of start scratching in where you can find an area. His parents are gonna be doing the landscaping and the plants and all that. You can't do it wrong, right?
Yes.
Okay. Wait, how can you do it wrong?
By not doing it at all.
There you go, it's all yours, man. Where's a hobby gonna go if we don't get kids? Learning how to do manual labor is everything, because he won't be afraid of anything anymore. If I don't bring people into this hobby, there's nobody else trying. I can see where Dan Hogue is gonna have a great time with steel bridges here. He makes steel bridges like no one else I've ever met. Hey Dan, do you ever think of making stuff out of something more than steel?
Everybody wants something unique on their railroad, yep. Whether it be a bridge, a building, a certain mountain. This is a Civil War bridge that we made. A guy said, can you do the Civil War bridge for me? It was like 13 foot long or something.
Does anybody ever say, make me a straight bridge?
I couldn't even believe it. I go, if we can do this, we can almost do anything.
Two separate radius. This is a prototype of a coal mine system. If you know the right person to ask, you find some lunatic like this, it'll build it for you.
I just blew two fuses right there. Okay, this is the part where they call it a job. When things don't work, you have to know what to do as quickly as possible. It's 12 city blocks in scale. No two buildings are alike. We have over 750 light bulbs in that town. That's a lot of lights, but it looks good. At night, it looks like you're coming in by helicopter. The owners of this home want to move in 21 days. To do that, this is going to be a putting green out here with a railroad around it. He walked me out on that property with a builder, an architect, and a designer, and they wanted to know where I was going to put the railroad so they could figure out where they were going to put the house. All right, let's find out if this thing works. The upper waterfall works. I love it when it all comes together. You're looking at a pristine backyard. That means I haven't been here yet. What we're doing right now is we're trying to find the backyard. There's just something that makes everybody 12 years old when they see one of these go by. We're also doing an overhead inside the house that is going to be below those brown rods on wooden timbers. And the track goes above them, and they go from his office all the way through to the garage. We got the trestles, all built by hand, stick at a time. We got the bridges. I know we got the water feature that you like. It's just simply tying up the golden spikes so we can run trains. Congratulations, the railroad is yours. Let's highball some trains, Wally.
All right.
And it's just like running a real railroad.
God, I love this.
Because as far as I know, I'm the only person on the planet doing this full time. So I'm pretty proud of myself. My mom's really scared. She doesn't think it's a real job.
If somebody comes out and looks at your railroad and they're in the house within 5 minutes, you wasted every dime you spent.
They do not believe that somebody will allow this in their house. Right over the shower, these things come to life every single time they move, and they're no longer toy trains.
Train's been christened. If you tell me you're gonna pick them up and put them away, I'm gonna walk out the door.
I've been doing this for 16 years, and I haven't had a day of work yet. I'm gonna drive everybody wild, also have
the only one there is around. Welcome to the newest job from the Empire Builder. Let's build a railroad. Congratulations.